You got a nice day for it. No, if it were raining, it might be depressing. And I could ruin these. Look, suede head.
New tights too, 30, didn't you?
30? She's in shock. They're M&S and they're 40.
I'm not in shock.
Well, you should be. I'll get you a ton of free bacon from Treadwell's.
Well, it was worth him dying, then.
No, she's right. I had a world of handouts when Alan was eviscerated. You picked a bad war, see? Loads of them dying. Not enough sympathy or sausage to go round.
Please, both of you. We had an agreement. I don't want to hear about you. Not today.
Of course, love. It's your special day. You make the most of it. Best of it.
Oh, looky, Lou. The last post. I never got this. Your granddad preferred Glenn Miller.
Today, lads, will you say goodbye to my gran for me? Don't let her touch you. Lovely service.
Yeah. Usually I wouldn't come to the after-show party.
The after-show party?
The wake?
Seriously, the after-show party. That is so incredibly inappropriate.
Well, how is wake any better? Think about it. It's actually kind of scary.
I suppose you're right, yeah. And now for the wake. Oh, Christ, we buried him. Now I miss laughing. Today when realise I've not laughed in ages, not smiled. Can see why people would have Botox now. Yeah, if you don't want people to know what you're thinking, or simply that you've got a big creased forehead. Like someone sat on it, or you're a confused elephant. That too would be a good reason. Am I babbling?
Yes.
I'll shut up.
It's adorable.
You always said that.
Not finished.
Mum, you were finished 30 years ago.
You want some help?
No, I'll just get this lot in the dishwasher, then I put the plates away.
I didn't want your life story.
Well, that were a good send-off, eh? Did a good spread.
Oh, yes, you did us proud. Though champagne isn't usual at a funeral, is it? And party poppers. Nevertheless, you showed them.
Showed who?
His parents, Matthew's parents. Look on their faces when they saw your prawn circle.
They just buried their son. I don't think a couple of crustaceans in a moonshake with a sprig of parsley and the Mary Rose sauce drizzled over just... Oh, they were green, weren't they?
As a cucumber.
Which nobody touched.
Well, they were all squaddies, weren't they? What they want is wartime ephemera.
Yeah, what?
Ephemera. Cakes and pies and prostitutes. There's the blushing bride seeing the parents off.
With a shotgun, I hope. You know, she wouldn't even pull a cracker just because they were as disowned. Snobbery. Weren't like I were asking her to wear the hat.
Billy will never see them again. Not without any kiddies, anyway.
Full of the joys of springtime, you, weren't you? Unlike the salad.
Well, you never saw Brian's parents again.
Well, that's more to do with the fact of me slashing their tyres when they said I'd stolen his pocket watch. He'd have wanted me to have that pocket watch, but when Brian's father popped it in the coffin, well, they were asking for trouble, if you ask me.
Well, who buries a perfectly good pocket watch? I mean, it's not like he needs it to check when Corrie's start... Oh! Is Corrie starting?
Mam! A man has died!
Oh! Thanks very much for spoiling it!
Not in Coronation Street! I'm talking about Billy's husband.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you're right. Mind you, it's a big storyline. Fatty's going to tell Ugly that she loves him, but she's actually pregnant with Backwards Baby.
Why can't you just learn names of characters?
I did 40 years ago, but they're all dead now.
Billy.
Yes?
How are you?
Don't ask her that. She's only a baby. She doesn't know. Drink up, love, and then drink another. But before you do that, pour one for me. To the top! Who do you think I am, Thumbelina?
What a day, eh? This war.
Oh, it's a lovely war. Diddly-dee. Sorry. Good tune, though, isn't it?
You don't think it'll happen?
Darling, it were Afghanistan. There were every chance. I mean, it's not like it were Ipswich or Coventry or Carlisle. They don't even have a cathedral.
It's just, you know, you expect them to come back, even if they said, like, you know, they got their hand blown off. You'd think, well, we'd cope. Without a hand, we'd still have three. Get a hook. Scare the kids off our allotment. Weed the cucumbers. Thanks, Gran.
I was actually reaching for the Baileys.
Oh.
But I'll hold your hand. You poor.
Poor what?
You poor the Baileys.
So what now?
What now?
Well, what now?
Well, we could play a game.
What, boggle? Yeah, that'll keep my mind off my dead husband, won't it? I'll just... Oh, look, I made spatula! That's far better than an alive husband.
Well, I played solitaire for a year when your dad died on computer at work. Used to go to bed and see Jackson Kings.
Who's Jackson Kings? What, I'm not allowed to make a joke? That's unfair.
Of course you're allowed to make a joke, love, but that was crap. No, when I was widowed, I played gin in silence with Betty Rose across the way. It would have been poetic silence, but poor Betty had been born without a roof to her mouth. So she could only ask for Hamwick. Hamwick. That's a sandwich. It was better for her to gesture.
Why would you gesture for a sandwich? That's crocodile.
Oh dear, poor Betty, all this time she was asking for a crocodile.
Well, we could play I Spy. I Spy with my little eye. Something beginning with S.
S. Solitude. Sad. Stupid war. Sick. Sad. Saddy. Sad. Sad.
Ah, well, it was salad. But all good guesses.
I
want to play a drinking game? Does anybody know one?
Yeah, there's one when you're watching Corrie, you take off...
No, ma'am.
How about I never?
What's that?
Rules are, person whose turn it is gets to say something they've never done, and if you've done it, you have to take a drink. So, I would say, I've never had a threesome.
Well, it was wartime.
Right, okay. How about I would say I've never killed a man, and say you had killed a man.
Please, Irene. I don't want to be in the army anymore. The way the world is at the minute, it'd be Borneo, Vietnam.
Stop making countries up! You have to, Alan.
And what if I got sent to war? Aden.
Only posh folk get sent to Aden. I've heard it on the news. The chaps are all in good spirits and morale is awfully high. Deli, belly, ho. You wouldn't fit in with your flat vowels and your flat cap.
I wish you had flat feet. What if I got killed?
Then I'd bloody kill you. And I like it if I was Swiss tree. I like the wives, the babies, doing each other's hair. I've learnt how to backcomb.
Is that safe?
As long as there's no ceiling fan.
I miss Korea by that much. They'll send me up for sure this time.
And you'll come back a hero, and we'll talk about you getting out then, when we scrape some money together, you, me and the baby.
Little Richard.
You, me and little Richard. Whole lot of shaking.
We didn't have any flowers at the funeral.
And you were gonna call me Richard?
Oh, my God, I do not suit that name.
Oh, sorry.
Hold on a minute. That's a bloody lie. You're always making up stories, you. Dad wanted to go up.
How do you know, Richard?
No, you've told me this a million times. What happened was...
What kind of a man would I be if I didn't go? I have to, Renee.
But you could leave. We could go back up north.
It's not what I signed up for. I signed up to defend our country.
You've always entertained becoming a florist.
Where have you got this idea from? I have hay fever. I don't even like flock wallpaper. Be back before you know it.
In a box?
Subtle as a pork in the pants you are. I promise you with all my heart, I won't die. And if someone comes running at me with a bayonet, I'll run really, really fast. I've had practice. Met your dad.
I could have stopped him, though. The guilt. I could have injured him so that he couldn't fight. I could have given him a club foot or a cleft palate.
You're born with those things, Gran.
In my day, you had to buy them. Oh, I could have broke his leg. I've got an iron. Oh, he was so... He was... Well, he was a bit ugly, but I did love him.
But there was nothing you could have done. Well, sometimes I think to myself...
Billy, can you pop these in the dresser?
I was in the middle of a bloody thought then. It was going to be wistful and everything.
Wisteria won't get these glasses put away.
Oh, my God! I can't believe you're asking me to do things today. That's so unfair. You two got to mourn for ages. What did I get? 3 hours? I'm like the drive-through widow.
Hey! I had to get back to the hospital straight after Alan's funeral because your mum was so sick. You nearly died, didn't you, love?
Hello? Excuse me, glasses. So you two are a right pair of martyrs, aren't you?
Oh. I'm a tomato. You're a tomato. We're all tomatoes.
Why does she do that?
I don't know. It's like she has to say something.
Something. Bum thing.
All right, yeah, you're still here like a bad smell.
Actually, I've just trumped.
Natalie, come here.
No, this has to stop, especially now.
Why especially now? You can see more of me. I'll show you my Bible. It's hardback.
Wouldn't want to, it's weird.
I'll take my collar off, come on. It'll be just like a regular man, only Jesus will be judging. I personally find that hot.
You stop with the creepy, sexy vicar act. It doesn't work on anyone below the age of 70.
It so does, you fell for it. And I've seen your gran eyeing up my crucifix.
Can you blame her? It's got a naked man on it.
Billy.
Look, you are a man of the cloth, which makes this ultra confusing. Shouldn't you be...
What? Attending to the flock? Nah. They're all a million year old. They'll be napping or... Isn't Corrie on? I hear Fatty's pregnant with backwards baby.
Stop it! What would God say if you were late back?
I don't know. Probably vengeful stuff. Anyway, he's late all the time. The Jews are proper annoyed about it.
What are you still doing here? I can't see you anymore. I don't want to see you now.
Look, I'm not here for me. I'm here for you.
No!
It's my job. I'm a comfort.
You're a bumfort. Sorry, my gran's got the same affliction. It's not seriously. You should go. Time's getting on.
I don't want to. I want to be with you. Billy.
But just leave, will you? I feel guilty enough.
So, in point of fact, I literally have never actually killed anyone. Feel a bit sad now the guilt's gone. Maybe I should buy some strychnine and dispatch a few cats.
I've killed someone.
I knew Snuffy didn't go to that farm.
Not that. And Snuffy did go to a farm, one past Cockermouth, where we get her eggs.
Oh, I know.
Really?
Really? Where the farmer promptly put a bullet in the back of his head.
Oh, my God, how could you do that?
He were dangerous.
He was a gerbil.
A gerbil from hell?
Well, you could have just stamped on him. Anyway, love, you were saying you killed someone.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I have.
Jackie.
Oh, Doctor. Oh, you just missed it. Sat up, took his tube out and asked for a steak butty.
Jackie.
Now I told him he had no ketchup, so he's sulking.
I wanted to talk to you.
About organ donation?
No, it's a virus. It would be unsafe to donate organs.
A virus? When you first said a virus, I thought you meant like a cold. But this isn't like a cold, is it? This is like a death. A really, really boring one. You know, my dad were in the army. Blown to bits in Borneo before I were born. That's a lot of bees, isn't it? Anyway, a hero he was. But this, Brian, now, another bee. Not so heroic.
Jackie, we talked about how if Brian ever came round, his quality of life would be...
Bee!
His quality of life would be poor. We don't know how much his brain has been attacked, but we do know he may still lose his leg, at least some fingers, and his kidneys aren't working any longer.
Have you got any spares? Big place like this, you think you have kidneys and fingers coming out your ass?
I think you need to consider the possibility that he isn't coming back.
You're ever so dramatic. You should have the EastEnders beats following you around. Oh, I know what you want to do. You want to pull the plug.
We don't call it that.
No, but that's what it is, though, isn't it? I mean, I thought I killed the old man in the next bed when I pulled his drip out with me flannel.
You what?
Nothing. So, you want to pull the plug?
We'd stop medicating him and he'd slip away.
How long, Doctor?
Within hours.
Within hours. I could be hours away from a hot bath in my own bed, Brian. Bath. Bed.
Jackie, love, I'd no idea.
Yes, you did, you mad old bastard. Told you that a million times. And I've carried the guilt with me all this time. I'll never get over it, never.
Oh, shut up. God, you love the guilt. You love the guilt.
You wear it like a badge, like a big badge from a competition. Who's the best widow?
You are. It's your day. Can't imagine where you get the idea I like guilt.
Probably the wearing of black for a full year. The random every time you hear your special song.
Everyone sighs when they hear Ernie, the fastest milkman in the West.
Let's sing a song from Borneo. I know he dong a langa.
God, you're an old racist.
They killed my husband, them.
You pay. I've got no right to wallow. This is my time to wallow.
All right, love, help yourself.
Well, I don't know how. I've had no practice what with Matthew only just dying, and I'm going to need you two to show me, you moribund harridans.
What's a moribund harridan?
Don't you ever get sick of being here?
What, you want me to go?
I do. Just answer me one question.
If it's will it do you on the coffee table, then I'm going to have to decline. Weird salad.
Was it my fault? Was this my fault?
Oh, it's a war. This is what happens. It's nobody's fault.
They're guilty. Mum and Gran, they've chosen to feel guilty about Grandad and Dad. Dad.
And how are you going to feel?
Well, it's too early to tell. I suspect I'll feel just as bad, probably forever, and then never, ever have sex again, as I so desperately want to believe they never did.
Why would you feel guilty?
You sure I shouldn't just back the car over your hand?
I haven't done that since our wedding day. My ring's still bent out of shape.
Matthew. I don't want you to go.
I don't really want to go myself. I'm not a fan of the kebab. Not the sober version.
There's a sober version.
And the whole getting shot at thing, I'm not that keen on that.
Well, they'd never shoot at a chaplain. It'd be like farting at a nun.
I'm not sure they'd really care about my faith. The dog collar's more of a handy target than anything. Cheers.
OK, Captain, there you go.
So this is goodbye, then?
No. Last night was goodbye.
God's listening.
Well, he better not have been watching. I was unholy.
You are my little fallen angel. I'll give us a kiss.
I miss you.
Ah, you won't have time. You'll be back in August. You'll be sick of the sight of us.
Never. Except when you do that turtle impression.
Oh, this one?
Stop it. Be gone with you. I love you.
I love you too. Ta-ra.
The last thing I did was flick you the V's.
So rude.
Stupid man, why did you have to go and get yourself killed?
Fun. I did it for fun, so we could have happy times like this together. I'm saying, Bill, your mum and your gran, they're grieving too.
It's my funeral.
I think you'll find it's mine. Are we learning opera? Me, me, me. Let them tell stories. And tell yours too. That's how I'll be remembered.
Billy, love.
gets on my wick.
Yes, we know, ma'am, but Sue Lawley exists, so get over it.
No. Well, war widows. They got all the good songs. They got Churchill. They even got dibs on the poppy, and that's supposed to be for all of us. What do you think of when you see a poppy? You don't think of Borneo. You don't think of Afghanistan. You think of bloody old Vera Lynn and Wilfred Owen moaning on about his gayness.
Did you talk to him?
Who? Vera Lynn and Wilfred Owen? Not since the threesome.
Right. Talk to who?
Grandad, my dad.
Billy, love, I don't think you quite grasp the concept of death.
I talk to Alan. I don't mean that he's here in the room, but... well, he... he's here. In the room, he's here.
Oh, yeah, right. Yeah, I do that. It's like I were devastated when the smell of brine had gone, but I got the remote control back. Even then, I'd watch Top Gear just to have an argument with him, you know.
I make cabbage. Even now, I hate cabbage. I'm sitting there at my table, pushing it round my plate, just to hear him laughing. I say to him, I might not like cabbage, but you're ginger. Oh, he gets so offended. The dead idiot.
Love, it's okay to talk to them. You're okay.
You are. And when you start getting those sex dreams, that's also okay. What? I'm still a woman. I've still got one.
You're right. I'm okay.